Hey, folks, welcome to InTheMoneyStocks.com's live trading action video. My name is Gareth Soloway, Chief Market Strategist here. Today's date is Tuesday, December 4th, 2018. As you can see, the markets are basically just off of their lows of the day. Huge collapse today. Markets at one point were down 3% across the board, and then we saw a little bit of a bounce here. Now, this bounce was very choreographed by the administration. Basically, what you had happen was Navarro was pushed out on TV. And this, by the way, was planned. I mean, so think about it from Trump's perspective. He basically came out. He saw what the markets were doing today. They were in free fall. He told Navarro, get on TV, calm the markets, talk up the deal with the potential deal with China. That's exactly what he did. And that's why the markets popped here. But notice how the markets aren't seeing an extended pop. If this was 2 months ago, we would have shot all the way back to the flat line. It's not happening today because the market is becoming kind of more adept at reading the boy that cried wolf type scenarios. And that's exactly what's happening here, folks. I mean, bottom line is, yesterday the markets gapped up because there was all this euphoria, you know, oh, a deal, you know, based on what Trump said, at least there's a potential deal and tariffs won't be raised. And then overnight, since yesterday morning, we slowly heard more and more. There were huge disparities with what China said the deal was and what the U.S. said. I mean, way off, like as if there was no deal at all. And then we heard that it was only a delay of these upper tariffs for 3 months. Okay, well, that starts January 1st. Then we found out it started December 1st. So really, that's only, you know, from January 1st, that's only 2 months until we have to deal with this whole shenanigans again. Bottom line is, that's why you got this bounce, but the markets are not buying it. In fact, I wouldn't be surprised to see this market come back towards the lows of the day by the end of the day. Many people yesterday, when I took profits at the open on all of our longs, we had five winners yesterday in the research center. Most of them were 10% plus. And then multiple 60% plus winners in the options alerts yesterday as well. Most people were like, well, why don't you let the market, you know, let it keep running? You know, why not try to make more? Well, this is why, folks, because yesterday I did a video and I talked about how the markets had rallied 17 points to yesterday's gap higher on the spiders. That's 170 S&P points. I mean, that's a huge move. Huge move. I mean, that's basically like a deal gets done. Boom. Well, guess what? A deal didn't get done. Markets are realizing that now, and here you sit on the markets right here. So pretty amazing stuff, but it just shows you in this market, you need to be nimble. You know, if you're not reading the charts, I mean, I was reading the charts yesterday, and I saw resistance on the gap up. Sell into it. Sell into resistance. Take profits. That turned out to be huge. Now, today I've already put out two new swing trades. We also picked up an additional position, added to a different position as well. I picked up two new options trades as well. So we're getting right back in the mix because, in all fairness, this market is going to be choppy into year end. You know, yesterday people were ridiculously bullish. Now today people are ridiculously bearish. There's some middle ground here. Markets are going to go up. They're going to go down. They're going to go up, down, up, down. There's a lot of money to be made if you can read the charts properly. And that's what we're here doing, folks. In fact, one of the options trades I put out today, we're already up 10% on that. Easy move there. And we'll end up probably making about 50% on that within a couple days. The swing trade alerts already looking amazingly well as well. So good stuff there. All right, but bottom line is that's what's going on here today. Interestingly enough, the lows of the day, if we flip over to the daily chart of the spiders here, the low of the day here from this low, check out this, guys. I think this is so cool to see. So this low to this high, okay? Look at that. Basically a 618 retrace on the Fibonacci. So very cool to see that, and gives you a little bit of a basis. I actually think the spiders will ultimately come lower. There's a little bit of a pivot right here at the 268.5 level, and I think that's probably where we're headed by well, markets are closed tomorrow, but probably before the end of the week. And then I think we probably bounce back up again. I think you're going to see Trump, anytime this market starts to get a little hairy, you're going to see him talking about positives and trying to trump out, you know, pun intended there, a deal is almost done or this and that. And so it's going to keep the markets, even the markets don't necessarily believe it, it's going to keep the markets from really collapsing sharply lower, at least until we get into January. So in my opinion, we're just going to continue to go sideways. The only thing I will warn people of is that what pattern is this creating? You have this big move down from the all-time highs here down, and then what's this chop creating. It's creating a bear flag. So what this tells me is that once you get into mid-January, I would be very nervous. In fact, I hope to be short, heavily short by that point, because we'll be looking at some major downside. Yesterday, it's so funny, the talking heads on TV, whether it was on Fast Money or some, I mean, there was like a Oppenheimer guy talking about, you know, market's going to rally 7% by year end from yesterday's close, no doubt. Well, guess what? Now the markets are down 2.5%. Now it's basically a 10% rally before the end of the year, if that's going to be proven right. That will not happen, folks. Now, I'm not calling for a collapse here in the end of January. I think it's just going to be sideways. You're going to go down through 2 or 3%, then up 2 or 3%. You know, it's going to be one of those type of markets, which if you're a trader is amazing. For instance, just to give you an example, in the intraday stock chat today, 7 for 7. 7 for 7 trades. I mean, that's that. Think about that. 7 trades, 7 winners today in the chat room because we have the volatility. You give me this type of action, I can make money with my eyes closed, and I can help every trader out there make money. I mean, that's just how awesome it is. So bottom line is, get your butts over to In the Money Stocks. Check out our track record, folks. I mean, track record verified. Take a look at it. It's on the under the free services on our website. You can see the Research Center track record. I mean, there's some losers up there, but I mean, we're up like 800% for the year if you add up all the winners and subtract the losers, 800%. Even if you just put 10% of your portfolio, you're talking 80% gain. Now take a look at the best performing hedge funds for the year. The average hedge funds this year are negative. And we're busting it out with, like, basically a conservative person's up 80% for the year. Ask any one of our members, folks. They're just crushing it. It's why our membership has never been bigger right now. Because people realize that this is the only game in town. There are plenty of other services that are BS. This is the one that puts out real trades, real timestamps, real verification. It's all there. Have a great one, guys. Come join us at InTheMoneyStocks.com.